Holy, holy, Blessed Trinity.
Dear Lord, thank you for this day that you've given us, Lord. Thank you for the doors to be open for us to come in and worship you. God be with Brother Jenny as he continues to lead us in song, and with Brother Dwayne as he brings the message that you have put on his heart. Lord, those that are sick and not be able to be here, Lord, we just ask that you heal them. Get them back into your house, Lord. For those, for whatever reason, are not here, Lord, we just ask that they put it on their heart and they come back to see you. Lord, again, thank you for all that you did for us. Please forgive me my sins and give us my heart. Amen.
Amen. Well, good morning. It is good to be in the house of the Lord today. As we come into this week here that is just following Thanksgiving, pre to the coming of the Christmas season. So, take your bulletins and this morning, and of course the church is still collecting socks and lotions from Street Tree Nursing Home through December the 14th, okay? As far as Thanksgiving goes, I hope all had a wonderful Thanksgiving holiday that was filled with God's bountiful blessings. Hope that each and every family celebrated the love of our Lord and Savior and gave thanks to God above for all that He is and has and will do in our lives. This coming Friday, December the 2nd, is First Friday Night Singing of One Accord, and the Wilbanks will be in concert. Starts at 7:30. It's an Inspiration Church for Most Lane Baptist, for those that don't know what it is. Anyway, it's a good time and everything, so we hope that you will support that. And of course, there's always something on the back of the bulletin as well that's worthy of your attention. As you sat down today and you saw that you had these books on your pew, these are part of your Christmas from us, but still, it is a 25-day devotion. It starts on December the 1st and goes to Christmas, and it is Bring On the Merry, 25 Days of Great Joy for Christmas. And when we got these, and then we got to actually looking in them and reading in them, it's a wonderful book, and I challenge each and every one that to take these and take just a few moments on every day and read the devotion and do the things that are follow it, and it'll truly be a blessing to you, and it'll be uplifting to you, to what God has done for us. And again, by doing so, It'll help to put your heart into that place of worship unto the Lord. So I hope that you'll do it, and that you like the books and things. I like books, and so I hope it'll be a blessing to you.
Let's continue in song this morning. Turn the page. 231.
Strength and honor,
give to his holy name. Like a shepherd, Jesus will guard his children. In his arms he carries them all day long. Praise him, praise him, tell of his excellent greatness. Praise him, praise him, ever in joyful song. Praise him, praise him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer. For our sins he suffered and bled and died. He our rock, our hope of eternal salvation. Hail him, hail him, Jesus the crucified. Sound his praises, Jesus who bore our sorrows. Love abounded, wonderful, deep and strong. Praise him, praise him, tell of his excellent greatness. Praise him, praise him, ever in joyful song. Praise him, praise him, Jesus our blessed Redeemer. Heavenly portals, loud with hosannas ring. Jesus, Savior, reigneth forever and ever. Crown him, prophet and priest and king. Christ is coming over the world victorious. Power and glory unto the Lord belong. Praise him, praise him, tell of his excellent greatness. Praise him, praise him, ever in joyful song.
Amen. Man, let's go right across the page. It's so sweet. Page 232. 1, 2, and 4, we'll stand on the last before we take our morning off. Here we go.
It's so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I bring him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus, just to trust his cleansing blood, just in simple faith to plunge beneath the healing cleansing flood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I pray him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I'm proved Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him.
Our Heavenly Father, we just thank You so much for being who You are this morning. Heavenly Father, as we learned in Sunday school this morning, we just hope that everyone's basket is full this morning. Father, we just ask You to be with us throughout the rest of this service. The words that You've given Brother Wayne to speak this morning that opens our hearts and ears to the mighty word of Your Heavenly Son. And Father, dear souls, we need to trust in You. Father, without You, we have nothing. Father, we just thank You. We just give You all the thanks for everything that You've done, going to do, and what You've already done. Father, so many still feeling sick in our church. There's so many that are just sitting at home for whatever reason. Father, we just ask You to interfere or enter in their hearts, Heavenly Father, and speak to them and get them back in Your house to hear word. Father, again, I just love You for all that You do, the mercy and grace You give us each and every day. I ask You to take this offering this morning that's being given to You, that You do it to Your will, to Your house, Heavenly Father. We ask You to forgive us all our sin if we fail against Thee and are going to fail against Thee. In Your precious name, amen.
Amen.
Did I mention that?
ago, we find that Thanksgiving has come and gone, and we find that it's gone into Black Friday and Cyber Monday, unfortunately, but it has. Just because that the Thanksgiving holiday has ended for 2022, it doesn't mean that we, as God's children, have to quit our Thanksgiving. We must continue thinking of and thanking Him for His many bountiful blessings. You know, we had our church Thanksgiving dinner last Sunday after the morning service, and in that we were going to have a time of praise and testimony. Well, we got kind of sidetracked a little bit, and it didn't happen the way that we had intended, but needless to say, there's nothing that says that we can't do that today in our morning service here. And so I was just wondering if anybody had a word of testimony or praise today for what the Lord has done.
Dear Lord, I just want to thank you for the doors of this church continuing to be open, Lord, that we can worship you Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, with this beautiful house that you have given us, Lord. Thank you for our pastor and his wife, for all the things that they do for this church and for the families of this church. Lord, again, just want to thank you for everything that you've done for me and my family. I know the COVID's been a rough couple of years, but I just give you all the honor, glory, and praise that I'm able to be in your house, Lord. Again, for the husband that you've given me, for the family of my children, my grandkids. Lord, this community to you, people who watch over them. Give you all the honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
I just want to thank God for many things. As we studied in Sunday school this morning, we take so much for granted. On talking about myself, where I was 20, 30 years ago, was nowhere near close to God. Doing things I should have been doing, knowing better, but still doing them. I just thank God where I am today. Without Him, I wouldn't be where I am today.
Amen.
That's having a loving Savior in my heart, a beautiful family that He's given me, a beautiful wife that I surely don't deserve, but she puts up with us so much. Kids, grandkids, love them all. At times, they can be, what do you want to call it? I don't know if the word is a distraction, but sometimes they can be an anthem. But I love them, and God has done tremendous things in my life. He's kept my dad here so far. I just continue to pray for him, and I know he wants to be here so bad. The reasons and the things that are happening with him, he just can't do it. As I said, just thank you for you, for Sister Lori, for the members of our church, thank Father. As we learned earlier last month, dear Father, closing of the church, some dear friends, we just take for granted sometimes that what we have is, what we gave. Well, it's not what we gave, it's what you gave us to give. And Father, I thank Him for keeping these doors open. No matter how much many it is, whether it be 1, 2, 20, or whatever the number may be. You know, he just does magnificent works in this house. And we've all seen, I mean, through illness and everything, what God could do. Prayers are definitely answered in this church. We've seen it. We've seen it work. Whether it's somebody that we've been praying for to either be healed or or taken home so he would have eternal life. And what God does, what God needs to do. And, you know, again, I just thank him for everything. You know, I'll be 67 next month. Long time, 67 years. But in those years, there's been a lot of trials in my life, a lot of changes in my life. But as I said, these last changes that were made by the grace of God. And I'll continue to praise him and give him whatever he asked me to give. Because he is my loving Father. He is the number one person in my heart. He will always be number one in my heart. My wife will be number two, but she understands that. So, again, I just thank this church for everything that they do and what they give us. Most of all, just give him all of the glory. Many sins that each and every day occur, and I thank him for continuing to let me work to support my family, and I'm just real excited and anxious about what he's got in store for these many years ahead.
Because to me, you're all worth it. I thank him for the wonderful thing that he's given me. heartbreaking. But God is still good, and He's not done here. He opened those doors, and He hasn't closed those doors. We still have the ability to keep the lights on and have running water and have a beautiful place to be in. And I'm just giving praise and glory for that. And for being able to put a new roof on, that we don't have to put swimming pools and trash cans out to catch the water. And that we were able to get the back fixed. And it's all beautiful. And it's all because of Him.
Yeah.
And I love you all. And I thank the Lord for y'all. And I just ask you to please continue to pray for me. And live with you. I had such a wonderful time with you. And I'm sorry for how some of it turned out. But it's getting better.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord, for all the many blessings that you bestowed upon me from my family. Thank you for letting me be with them up here in Pilgrim, all of them, some of the holidays. Thank you for the peace you have been giving me. Thank you for this church that you have blessed, dear Lord. Thank you for the people that are in it, that they are our extended families. Thank you for the pastor and his wife that has kept our hopes and our spirit filled. Please be with us for the upcoming holiday, the worship of you and the praise you deserve, and to celebrate the birth of your birth, and the reason with our as a Passover people that you are the reason for the season, dear Lord. Thank you for all your many blessings for all the people that are here today and all the members that are not here today, dear Lord. Please be with us all and help us keep our best fools, dear Lord. Each and every one of us with that test. Thank you for Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I like to say, you know, first and foremost, I give thanks to my Heavenly Father above. Because without Him, none of the things that I had just heard would even be possible. And I thank the Lord for allowing us the opportunity to serve here for these last 19 years. And we're looking forward to the years to come, if the Lord so sees fit. I thank the Lord for, of course, for my family and then for each and every one of you here at Calvary Baptist Church and all the friends that we have met down and in and through the years that love the Lord. You know, I give thanks to the Lord for allowing us the opportunity to go and to do things and then to thank Him for it. You know, to be able to come to Him with a basket full, just to praise Him. I thank Him for being able to have Thanksgiving lunch with my brother-in-law, Ron, in the hole, but to see the smile on his face when he saw us. He may not know everybody, but he always knows who I am. And I just thank the Lord for that. I thank him that we'll be able to go into this Christmas season realizing the true meaning of Christmas.
Yeah.
It was God's indescribable gift that makes Christmas what it is. I hope and pray that we will be able to be just, when people walk into this place, this Christmas, that they'll know that the Lord is in this place. And I thank him that Lori is feeling better. She's not where she ought to be, but she's better than what she was. And I thank the Lord for that. And, you know, as we lift up family, friends unto the Lord, that we can just give him thanks for them. Most of all, I just want to be able to express the love that I have for him. I wish I had a testimony like some people that, I got saved when I was just 4 or 5 years old, you know, and boy, the Lord's been with me and walked with me and everything all these years. I don't have a testimony like that. You know, I got saved when I was 33. But I've never been the same. You know, there were a lot of things that I just praise the Lord that he kept me alive to where I could get saved and trust him as my Lord and Savior. Because he knows that it would have been nothing for me to go, you know, to be taken away from this world. But I just thank him for it. I hope and I pray and I look forward to the hope that is found in my Savior Jesus for what's coming. This world is not my home. I'm just passing through this place. But we got to make an impact while we're here. And, you know, I'm thankful that he's allowed us to do that and that he is going to allow us to do those things. So anyway, I just wanted to be able to take a moment. We didn't quite do that Sunday, so we did it this Sunday, and things. So, you know, I hope and pray that that the Lord was pleased for sure. You know, I look and as I read and study and look in God's Word, it never ceases to amaze me what God has done, what He is doing and what He will do. Because it's all laid out within His Word. I look, you know, we talk about praise and worship and honoring and glorifying Him. Now I look in the book of Psalms, and I look at Psalm number 1, and it speaks in 6 verses of the man who is blessed. And then I can turn to the end of the book, and I can turn into Psalm 150, and it speaks in 6 verses of the God who is to be praised. I believe that there could not have been written an any more fitting conclusion to the book than that is found in Psalm 150. You know, this psalm literally answers 4 key questions about praise. And after all, I mean, you know, the word praise is only mentioned 13 times in 6 verses. So let's turn to the 150th psalm. And let's stand as we read it this morning for the next just few short moments. It says, "Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in the firmament of His power. Praise Him for His mighty acts. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. Praise Him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise Him with the psaltery and the harp. Praise Him with the timbrel and the dance. Praise Him with the string instruments and organs. Praise Him upon the loud cymbals. Praise Him upon the high-sounding cymbals. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord."
Amen.
Let's pray. Lord, we do come thanking you, Lord, and for this Thanksgiving season, Lord, and the call to remind us, Lord, that it's not just one day that we ought to be thankful, but it ought to be each and every day that we ought to be thankful. Lord, I pray that as we open your word today, Lord, that you would allow us to just see in these 6 simple verses what you would have us to see. And it's with that each and everyone standing said, Amen. We look and we find that there are 4 simple questions that can be answered in these 6 verses. For one, we find in question number 1 is, where should God be praised? Well, verse 1 says, "Praise ye the Lord, praise Him in His sanctuary, praise Him in the firmament of His power." You know, We got to realize that if we're talking about praising the Lord, that we got to realize where He is to be praised, and that where is everywhere.
Yeah.
In His sanctuary here on this earth, whether it be in our quiet time, in our prayer closet, whether it be in the midst of our church house, God is to be praised everywhere on this earth.
Yeah.
And to his heavenly creation, heaven above it, it says, praise him in the firmament of his power. You know, we have to realize that God not only created all that is here, but he created everything that we will see and will experience as a born-again believer. So, if we ever ask ourselves, well, you know, where should we praise God? Well, I'm telling you, we ought to be able to praise him anywhere, everywhere we are or we're going to be. Because he is worthy. He is worthy of our praise. Question two that we find in these verses is, why should God be praised? Why should I praise him? Well, if we're born again, that ought to answer the question enough. But, however, it says in verse 2, we find the why of our praise. It says, praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. If we can't come up with any other reason to praise him, then we need to praise him for his mighty acts, for the things that he does on our behalf. And not only that, but we have to praise him for his inherent greatness. We got to understand who God is. I mean, he is the creator of all that we know. He is the creator of heaven and earth. He is the creator of the universe. And he is the creator of the universe in which the universe is in. Everything that we know and what we don't know, he is the creator of it. So when we wonder, well, you know, why should I praise God? Well, let me ask you another question. Well, why not? Why shouldn't we praise God? Everything that we have and what we are and what has been done and is being done and will be done is all because of him. We come into Christmas, which it'll be in about 30 days from now or so. And we have to understand that we celebrate the birth of the Messiah, the birth of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. And yet, we lift up our praise, but if it wasn't for God, Christmas wouldn't even be here. We wouldn't even be coming into this holiday season. It was God's plan of salvation. And within that heavenly plan of salvation, God came to us in the form of the babe lying in a manger. He came to us in that holy incarnate babe. well, why should we keep you praying? We find question three that's answered in these verses. We find in verses 3, 4, and 5, it says, praise Him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise Him with the psaltery and the harp. Praise Him with the timbrel and the dance. Praise Him with the stringed instruments and organs. Praise Him upon the loud cymbals. Praise Him upon the high-sounding cymbals. What we find here, we've seen the where, and we've seen the why, and now we see the how that we're supposed to praise Him. And what the Bible gives us is the literal instruments of the day can be used in order to praise Him. Well, I give you that with any suitable instrument or manner, we ought to praise Him. No matter how, we ought to praise Him. Everything we do ought to be an instrument of praise unto the Lord. Everything that we are ought to be an instrument of praise unto the Lord. Because if we are living and we are celebrating and we are honoring and glorifying His holy name in no matter what we do, because we can do it no matter how we can. By getting up in the morning, we can praise and honor Him, because if we start our day with Him, then we know that we're praising Him. We praise Him in our walk, in the things we do, and why we do them, and how we do them. It praises Him. These are just, from what we can gather, I mean, we look at the psalmist. He gives us all these instruments as a way of showing us that, for one, it's not just one simple act or one simple instrument that is used to praise the Lord, but all instruments and all of the things that we do are instruments in praising the Lord, or they should be. We both know, or we all know, that there are those things that we do that don't please Him, that don't praise Him. But we can, and we should. Where and why and how? They all come and they all lead us to the who. Notice what it says in verse 6. It says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Who's supposed to be praised? The Lord. Who is supposed to be praising Him? Everything that has breath. Literally, if it has life, it is to be praising the Lord. Everything that has breath. Every verse of this psalm is cast in the form of a call to praise the Lord. There will come a day when every creature will in fact bow in praise to Almighty God. And if we are going to be anything in which that God would have us to be, then the things that we need to be doing are praising Him in how we live, the things we say, how we act, what we say, where we go. All of these things about us, everything about us, ought to be done in such a manner that it praises Him. Praise ye the Lord. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Because I give you, He is worthy of our praise. Everything. Now grasp this for a moment. Everything that is in heaven bows down before Him. One of these days, we will bow before Him. When He enters the room, we will bow before Him. When we enter the throne room of the Most High God, we will bow before Him. Why? Because He is worthy of our praise. He is worthy of our praise. Look at what He's done. Listen to the testimonies that you just gave. And tell me that He is not worthy of our praise. Because He is. You know, we have to turn today. We have to understand today. We have to realize today that today is a good day to praise the Lord. Yesterday, even though yesterday is gone, we can't change a single thing about it. Yet, yesterday was a good day to praise the Lord. We look to tomorrow. Now, many people, they'll get and they'll be, oh, the holiday is over with. I got to go back to work. And things. But I want you to hear me this morning that even as we look towards tomorrow, we must realize that tomorrow is a good day to praise the Lord. And it's a good day to praise the Lord because He is worthy of our praise. So when we stop and when we think about all that He has done for us, we need to think about our basket. Is our basket full of praise unto Him? Is our basket filled with praise that is worthy unto Him? Because a lot of things that we do are not worthy unto Him. heart must be in an attitude that is worthy unto Him. See, we literally don't walk in to wherever when we're going to praise the Lord with our little basket. We have our basket, and it is our heart. And our heart is either full for Him or it's not. And the only thing that determines whether it's full for Him or it's not is us. Everywhere we go, everything we do, every time that we go into His Word, every time we come into His presence, every time we step foot into His sanctuary, every time that we come into any place, thing, rhyme, or reason that deals with the Lord, which is basically anywhere, everywhere, all the time, our hearts ought to be full of praise unto the Lord. If for no other reason than because He is worthy of our praise. But I would think if we could stop just long enough, we could think of some reason to be thankful unto the Lord. I believe if we would find that our blessings outweigh our woes time and time and time over. So praise ye the Lord this morning, today, tonight, tomorrow. We're coming into the Christmas season, the most wonderful time of the year.
Amen.
I love Christmas. And I love Christmas not because of all the things that the world puts out in it. I love Christmas because of what God put in it. He put Jesus in it. That's the reason I love Christmas. And I love the decorating and making whatever, whether it's house, tree, or whatever, make it beautiful for Him. Because He is worth it. So when you leave here today and you happen to think back and about this time of Thanksgiving that we've just come through, for one, remind yourselves that we need to be thankful every day. But two, think back about what God has done. And let those thinkings bring you into the point to where you think of what God is doing. And that ought to bring you, it ought to be swelling up within you to what God is going to do in the future. One day, we are going to be able to see Him face to face, eye to eye. bow down before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords and praise Him. Because He is worthy of our praise. Let's all stand. Dear Lord, we do come thanking You, Lord, for this day that You blessed us with. Lord, it is another opportunity, Lord, to be able to come into Your very presence and to worship and honor and praise Your holy name. Lord, I thank You for the things that we've heard. Lord, as these have given testimony to what You are doing and have done and are doing and are going to do in their lives. And Lord, most of all, we come thanking You for what You did, You gave us in the form of Your Son Jesus. As Lord, as You placed that plan of redemption and salvation in action, Lord, I pray this upcoming Christmas season, Lord, that as each and every day goes by, that, Lord, our hearts would be filled more and more and more with You. Lord, I ask that You'd use, Lord, just the things that we have heard in this place this morning. Lord, that You would enable us to just realize how much You truly are worthy of our praise. Open our hearts this morning. Lord, if there's anything that may be within our hearts today, Lord, that keeps us from praising You, Lord, I pray that You would remove it so that that space can be filled with You. Use this invitation time as only You can.
Page 193. Surrender all to Him I
Thanksgiving, and we're able to just contemplate upon what the Lord has done for you. We'll be back in tonight and things, so I hope you'll be with us once again. You know, we pray as you know, we're coming closer and closer to 2022 being over and 2023 coming on. But you know, it doesn't mean that that we still don't have an opportunity to praise Him. Amen. Lord, we do come thanking You, Lord, for Your many blessings. Lord, we ask now that You would just use each of us, Lord, as Your instrument of praise, Lord. Lord, that we could realize that all that we are and all that we can be and all that we should be, Lord, is an instrument that is used to praise Your holy name. Lord, we just come before Your very throne today, Lord, asking that You would not only watch over us and lead and guide us, Lord, but Lord, that You would fill our hearts with You today, Lord, and that each and every day that our desire would be to have more and more and more of You. Lord, we love You and we thank You. Lord, take us from this place. Bring us back this evening, Lord. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.